Today, in many ways, is a celebration of vision and inspiration, which seems only fitting standing next to the Monon Greenway and home of this new artwork. Once an abandoned railroad, thanks to the vision of an organized group of residents and community leaders, today is so much more than a linear trail, but also a cultural hub and economic engine for our great community. And today, we are here to celebrate the vision of a truly talented young artist, inspired by music and the subtle natural beauty of Indiana, who designed this beautiful artwork that I have no doubt will delight and inspire Carmel residents and visitors for many years to come.
Going back to September 9th, 2020, Joe Fletchell called our office and suggested that, or mentioned she frequently walks on the Monon Trail, and suggested the city work with the Carmel High School Art Department to create murals for the Monon Greenway tunnels in Carmel. That's how communities make progress. Lots of good ideas from lots of people. Having art in public spaces is important for great cities. There's no great city on the face of the earth in any period of time that did not pay attention to great art, to art that inspired people, to inspired great ideas, to make the city more beautiful. And as a practical matter, it's good for economic development too. It helps create an identity, and it makes people from other places want to be here as visitors and possibly residents. It helps our companies recruit people if we have a beautiful city.
What a wonderful opportunity for one of our students to do what she loves to do and to have a real world experience of making what I would call a legacy project, that she's able to do something, create something, have it placed in our city, and then it'll be there for years and years and years to come. So congratulations, Carolyn, on just a wonderful job. And every time I walk through it, I'll go, I know Carolyn. So congratulations, thank you very much.
Jen Bopp happened to meet our next speaker in a local coffee shop, I believe. They were discussing the mural project and the challenge of safely and timely painting on the ceiling of the tunnel. We all had visions of Michelangelo and how to do that safely on a very busy trail. John Michael Polly, a CHS graduate, rose to the challenge, graciously donating his time and skills to identify a state-of-the-art solution to the task at hand.
It's been a wonderful opportunity for me. This is an incredible city, second to none. There's not a cracked tile. And I saw the back end of some of how that goes down, and from the Parks and Rec, the street department, it's incredible. So thank you, Mayor. It's a trickle down from you, and an honor. Thank you, guys.
I certainly can't tackle a project like this without many hands involved. And I think of the quote by Helen Keller that she said, alone we can do little, but together we can do so much. And so it begins with discussions. It begins with the ideas. It begins with those initial meetings of coming together. And then, of course, Caroline and her beautiful design. We put the challenge out to our National Art Honor Society students, gathering their ideas, having them brainstorm on paper. And that in and of itself was such an inspiration, where the students inspire the teachers. And when we saw Caroline's design, we knew instantly that this was the one that spoke to this space.
I didn't make this art just for artists or musicians, but for everyone to enjoy. I decided to take a little bit of Indiana and bring it into my design. I really love the sunsets here. I think they're so vibrant and so pretty. They're really something that stands out to me here. And I hope that it gives you a very ethereal feeling. At least that's what I was going for. Spreading wonder through the community. And I hope everyone enjoys it. I really hope.